Good morning, raccoons. You're invited to join us in the pledge. All right. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Okay, have a seat, have a seat, have a seat. I'll set two. I got a few things that I just want to go over as we wrap up homecoming week. First of all, thank you, everybody, for a great week, student council. But we owe a special shout out and a special sense of gratitude to Ms. Buchel and Ms. Fisher, who coordinate the whole week. It's a 6-day long party that they are working hard all year long on to help student council make the decisions they need to make and to help make sure we have the supports in place to make it happen. So if you see Fisher or Buchel, make sure you say thank you. Drop them an email. They deserve it. They worked incredibly hard, and we're looking at one right now. Other things is you need to know how incredibly proud I was at everybody at the parade, the energy. Your representation of Oconomowoc was awesome. Student section was great. Got a lot of compliments from alumni and probably things you don't know about homecoming, right? Saturday is kind of alumni day. We have a Hall of Fame induction banquet in the morning. And in the afternoon, we have tours of campus for alumni that are back in town for their class reunions. And they overwhelmingly, those that attended the football game, those that were looking at all our facilities and spaces, thought about how lucky you were and also how hard you must work with the opportunities that you have. So be proud to be a raccoon. Email. Oh my gosh, email. You got a school email address, and that's awesome. It's a great way of communicating back and forth, learning about different opportunities, talking with your counselors, all that. But a lot of us are using our school email to do personal things. So for example, a lot of you are applying for jobs, and you're using your school email to apply for that job. You're using your school email to apply for scholarships or for colleges. And we really shouldn't be, only because we have filters on our system that might slow down any responses. So if you're applying for a job at, I don't know, say Culver's, and Culver's emails you, that may not get through our firewall and our systems faster than it would if you use your personal email address. Plus, one day you're going to have to give up your school email. So seniors, right, you will lose your email shortly after graduation. And any email you have going there, you'll miss out on. We'll talk about how to forward that and all that down the road. But again, if you're not doing school-related things, it's life stuff like applying to colleges, scholarships, or jobs, use your personal email. Career College Life Readiness Day, I sent an email this morning, raccoons, outlining the details for October 17th. It's still a couple weeks away, but I want it on our radar. Special schedules, great things going on. Make sure you read that email, and we'll review it from time to time here on RCC. Oh my gosh, that's all I got.
Thanks to all who participated, from powder puff to volleyball to soccer to golf to window painting to the pep rally to the football game parade and then finally the dance. Thank you. Many of you were there and it was streamed, but in case you missed it, here are the winners of the homecoming parade. Best overall themes go to Park One. Best class goes to Manufacturing. Best school goes to Silver Lake. Best community goes to Thirsty Bird. Best club goes to FFA, and best sport goes to girls golf. Woo! Congratulations to all who participated and attended. We have a lot of interesting things happening in October, including our school play. If you are interested in being involved with the tech crew or backstage to a play this year, on October 10th, there will be an informational meeting for this year's play, Once Upon a Mattress, in the OAC for anyone who wants to join. Make sure to join the theater, arts, food classroom, and the OHS players classroom with the codes on the screen. Also, make sure to contact either Carson Klammer or Mrs. Tiersa for any questions or concerns. Athletes, do not forget to turn in your raccoon cards. The last day to turn them in is tomorrow morning from 6:45 a.m. to 7:15 a.m. Turn them in at the indoor concession stand by the main lobby. We need your help. We are collecting donations for our freshman CCLR Day project, Support the Troops Wisconsin. We are collecting donated items to fill care packages to send to active duty military serving overseas. The more donated items we get, the happier our active duty service men and women will be. They're far away from home serving our country, and they greatly appreciate any and all treats from home. On the screen is a list of items that can be donated. Donated items can be dropped off in room 314 on main campus and in room 516 on main campus, or at East Campus. Bring your items to school by October 16th. Wednesday, October 4th, this Wednesday in the rec, a representative from Marquette's ROTC program will be coming to visit to talk about higher education opportunities through the military. If you are interested, then sign up under Terry Schultz's Pride on OconomPride.org. Yearbook wants your homecoming photos.
That's not even on? Yearbook wants your homecoming photos. If you took any, make sure to send in your homecoming photos to lopnowt@oasd.org. Photos can be powder puff, weekly themes, sports, and any other miscellaneous photos.
Wait, I'm here. I'm ready.
We have Mr. Homecoming King, Michael Cortese, in the studio today to shave his head. How are you feeling, Michael?
Pretty nervous.
You ready, Ro? Let's do it. I mean, it's looking good so far, I think. Ro claims to be a professional. Yeah. Are you going to give him a fade, or, like, what's the deal here?
Who knows? I'm just going with the flow.
Ro, let's take some off the front. Let's go right down the middle. Let's go right down the middle, I think. All this just to win homecoming king, Michael. Well, no turning back now, because this would be something to walk back to school with. Just leave it there. All right, we'll check in with them in a couple minutes. Speaking of the yearbook before the haircut, they want your senior photos. The requirements and guidelines for the photos are on the screen right now. Scan the QR code for an easy upload or email Mrs. Lopnow at lopnowt@oasd.org. Or if you only have a hard copy, you can turn it in at the East Campus office. The deadline is November 3rd. Adventure Rock Climbing is having a free day tonight from 6:30 to 8:30. For more info, email CRIDELICHA@OASD.org with questions. Make sure to stop on by and have some fun. And this just in, Schultz's History Meets Art Pride tomorrow is rescheduled for tomorrow. So please schedule for tomorrow if you were originally scheduled for the original Pride date. Congratulations to both cross-country teams this Saturday who competed in cross planes. Boys varsity got first with Jaden, James, Mason, Bryce, and Max getting top 10. Boys JV got third with Isaac getting seventh, and congrats to Molly and Isabel for getting 10th and 15th place. Congrats cross-country. Next, we have Braden with our weekend weather report.
We have the week weather report, not the weekend weather report, but it's all good. So looking at the weather this week, we have hot and dry conditions today and tomorrow with mostly clear skies, highs in the 80s. Into Wednesday, a high of 76 degrees, partly cloudy skies with a small chance of rain. And then into Thursday, cooler with a high of 68 degrees and partly cloudy skies and also a chance of rain. And then a strong cold front will make its way Thursday night into Friday, bring cooler temperatures for Friday with a high of 58 degrees and partly cloudy skies with a chance of showers. So go out and enjoy the nice hot days we'll have the next few days before fall really sets in.
Thank you, Braden. Looks like a really nice week until Friday. Do not forget to follow us on YouTube at OHS Digital Productions and Instagram at OHS_RCC. And as always, share your news with our team at rcc@oasd.org. And here is Mr. Curtis with the joke of the day. He's scrambling. He lost his joke. Oh. And Michael is still getting a haircut, but here's the joke.
I can't believe this is happening. You look like a sixth grader now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's good. All right. Why did the cookie go to the doctor? It's weird. Why did the have the best day of your life, raccoons?
If you're still tuned in, Michael does not have nearly as much hair. You actually had a lot of hair.
I did.
You guys can't see the back of his neck, but there's a lot of hair. And bro, it's honestly a good haircut. Like, you might have to give him a tip.